Van Riemsdyk screening. Francis. Phaneuf shoots, just missed the net. Trying to pick a corner. The Leafs get the puck back. Canucks couldn't clear it. Dion Phaneuf again. Kessel's in a shooting position. The shot went to the net. Kessel on the rebound. Francis. Van Riemsdyk lets the puck go. Kessel turns off the boards. Brad Richardson pressured him. Knocked the puck loose. Couldn't clear it. Francis with room. Shoots long with a save. And a beauty, too, but the Leafs couldn't get a hold of the rebound. There was a couple of them there. Alexander, he's Olympic bound. So is Daniel Sedin, who bounced the puck to center, and Vancouver scrambles to change. Gunnarsson right back into Jay McClement. With David Clarkson headed to the front of the net, that's where the puck goes, and Luongo kicked it away. Morgan Rielly taking a shift here with Paul Ranger. I believe this is his first of the game. Up the middle, Bozak to Van Riemsdyk, snaps the shot into the glove of Roberto Luongo.
Treatment on there.
He's won the draw. Gleason shot kicked out by Luongo. Raymond Fenn, in fact, his stick broke in half. Troy Bodhi to the blue line. Riley's quick shot. Luongo has to make another save, and he's in a shooting gallery right now as the Leafs own the game but haven't been able to score a goal. They've outshot Vancouver 6-1.
No, you had to figure a game plan coming in, get everything to the net, and there's a good combination of pucks and bodies. You can see as Luongo kicks that rebound out, a great chance for Raymond, but his stick explodes. But once again, Luongo with traffic, bodies flying in on him, does a nice job of holding on and getting a whistle.
He's playing with Zach Dalpe and Tom Sestito here in the fourth line. They're trying to change, and in come the Maple Leafs. Kadri shoots, Luongo fought it off, and he fought the rebound right by Nazem Kadri. Frank Corrado got a stick in the face. Higgins comes back the other way. There's going to be a Toronto penalty on the play. There's a long shot off the wing. And Jonathan Bernier tested by Yannick Hansen, and Vancouver is going to get a power play. Corrado gets a hold of the puck and gets it deep. Higgins, Hansen in front, pass hit the back of the net. Schrader to the blue line, walking the line. Corrado passes off. Schrader shoots right into the glove of Jonathan Bernier. Toronto's penalty killing has been getting better again. It's not very good, 28th in the league, but in recent games they've killed 12 of their last 13 penalties. Here's Kessler right up the middle, shoots, and a nice save by Bernier. Back to the blue line. And Ryan Stanton into Brad Richardson. Nice move to get open, and a backhander stopped by Bernier. And it's a good thing he stopped that, because Cassian at the side of the net was there for a tap-in. Bozak up the middle. Kessel was there as well, and the pass is swatted away in a 3-on-2 the other way. Daniel Sedin. Alex Burrows stops up, feeds the trailer. Ham Hughes stopped by Bernier. The middle. Here's Yannick Hansen with his shot. And Bernier, who's getting busier, made another nice save. Here's Ryan Kessler with a shot. He scores! Canucks needed a break, and they get a lucky one there as that went off Jonathan Bernier and into the net, and Vancouver's Ryan Kessler makes it 1-0 Canucks.
Oh, a shocking goal by Bernier. He can't believe that that one got by him. And Glenn would attest to this more. It's been an interesting period for him. Not much action first. Here's a good blocker save early on. The puck goes around, and the Vancouver Canucks able to keep it in. An innocent-looking play, and just didn't read it. It was a knuckler a little bit, as you could see the quick release. But off his blocker and down. And
Daniel Sedin to Jordan Schrader with Alex Burrows. There's the shot that's blocked by Gunnarsson. And he goes after Schrader. Daniel Sedin gets the puck to Garrison. Takes the shot. Bernier makes the save. Zone, sharp angled shot. And Luongo steered that aside. Ruffle and Kadri battle for the puck with Kellen Lane and Alex Edler. Clarkson gets it to put up this shot. Stopped, and the rebound is chipped into the corner after Luongo made the initial save. The Leafs, who only dressed 11 forwards tonight, are down to 10, and they're missing a very good penalty killer in center iceman and Jay McClement. Alex Burrows for Jordan Schrader. Couldn't get the puck through. Then he took a shot. Kicked away by Jonathan Bernier.
Gives you a little bit of a buff. Toronto's been great.
Yannick Hansen to Edler, and he shot just wide. The rebound off the boards, and Bernier had to get across and made a nice save on Ryan Kessler. Phaneuf gets the puck. Steered wide. He put the puck into the corner, trying to take a shot on goal. Carl Gunnarsson on the other side. Van Riemsdyk. Phaneuf shoots, and Luongo makes a nice save, and he's looked pretty steady. That's a dozen shots he's faced against the Leafs.
Well, in the first period, it was traffic in front of Luongo. He's looking through bodies. He's having a hard time tracking the puck. Here's a great chance with a hard shot, but look at the front of the net. All vacated. Nice box out by Garrison.
Gardner steps to center and dumps the puck in. Mason Raymond first on it. Troy Bodie, good is up front. Bodie battles to get the puck. Raymond's wrap around and Luongo coolly scoops up the puck.
Well, you can sense a little bit of energy in the building. A couple of plays to get the puck in deep, and the speed of Raymond coming out of the corner. Bodie keeps it alive. Good support down low. You can see a chip puck and an excellent read by Luongo, though. He was already there on 6 feet of ice.
And that's why Zach Kassian hasn't been able to break into their top six on a regular basis. Kessler, Hansen, Bernier. Gunnarsson got strafed by Richardson with his stick. Bozak carries the puck in. Kessel's right behind him. Canucks back to center. Here's Alex Burrows down the wing. Shoots the puck. Bernier makes the save. John Tortorella sent out his fourth line. Centering pass. Dalpe gets a hold of it off of Tim Gleason. Back to the blue line. Hamhuis sets up Garrison. He fires and Bernier found that. That's a hard, heavy shot.
The worst part of it will be the weigh-in.
Yeah.
How'd you do on your break?
There's Dan Hamhuis with a long shot, and Jonathan Bernier stopped that up high. Leafs with numbers through center. Phil Kessel for Joffrey Lupley got the puck through to Kadri, and he tried to feed it in front. Kessel with a shot. What a save by Luongo off Phil Kessel. Another shot up high, and then hit Tom Sestito. Leaves it in the corner. Mason Raymond to Cody Franson. On the other side, Jake Gardner. Back to Franson. He shoots just wide. Clarkson on the rebound couldn't shoot. Raymond with his shot stop. Another shot wide of the net. This time by Kuhlman. Eli Kuhlman. Mason Raymond. And out. Racing onto the puck is Troy Bodie. Raymond trying to join in. Gets a shot. A deflection. And Roberto Luongo had to make a brilliant save. That just about dipped under his glove. And the Canucks don't look very good in their own end right now. Mason Raymond from behind the net. Gunnarsson's in front. He scores! Former Canuck Mason Raymond ties the game 1-1.
Boy, momentum is a real powerful thing. And this is a shift that just kept building to a crescendo. Chance after chance. Luongo at the one chance thought he had the puck. Look at the body standing around. Hamhuis is down. And a perfectly placed shot with patience by Raymond. Watch him keep his feet moving here. He's got his head up the entire time. And just that quick release. Glenn, you probably had a perfect vantage point of that one.
New game tied 1-1, third period.
You gotta think that one feels pretty good of all those 16.
Booth with a shot. Bernier with a save. Richardson right there looking for the rebound as the Canucks bounce back and just about got ahead again. Boards, Daniel Sedin tipped the puck through. Here's a two-on-one. Jordan Schrader with Alex Burrows. Burrows stand on it. And he still hasn't scored, and that's the kind of season it's been. Burrows to the front of the net, trying to bank one, and he goes to the net. Gets a rough ride from Gunnarsson as Bernier makes the save. Bozak and Ringsdyke stationed in front. The extra attacker is on a delayed penalty call against the Canucks. Kessel shoots his scores! Number 31 for number 81, and Toronto has the lead 2-1.
Oh, this was all Kessel. He drew the penalty, the delayed call on Richardson, and then just kept the play alive. And a heads-up play with traffic in front. I mentioned earlier how Luongo looking through the bodies. A chance for the puck there. The slash and the overreaction by Kessel drew the call. And you could see Richardson didn't like the call. Swooping around, Bozak keeps the play alive, doesn't allow the Canucks to touch it. And then look at the big body of Van Riemsdyk. Here's that pairing again.
There's Bozak back in. His lines really come alive. Center pass, Kessel just wide of the net. Another penalty coming up. They score! Another delayed penalty call. And another Toronto goal, and it's a 3-1 Maple Leaf lead.
Speed again. It creates problems, and it's on a back check. Watch number 7, Booth. He's got the stick into the stick area of Bozak. Bozak keeps it alive. A bad bounce. Glenn, you said bad puck luck. Look at number 23 again. Edler knocked one in Montreal, and that one goes almost off his face as Van Riemsdyk from a bad angle. and the bad luck continues for the Canucks.
You can't draw that up, can you?
Again, in a good position defensively as the center, and now offensively two on one. Kuhlman stops up, shoots long, had to make a great blocker save. Dan Hamme is trying to hold the puck in, can't. It's knocked down. Here comes Van Riemsdyk. Kessel streaking to the net. There's the pass, tipped just wide. Tipped out of the air and just wide by Phil Kessel. That's Gleason without his stick. He's trying to pick it up, and he's got it again. He has. Richardson's in front. Kessler's in front. Booth has the puck to Alex Edler. He shoots the deflection. Bernier got a hold of the puck, and then he lost it. Olympic Prime with Ron McLean still upcoming after this game that is, thanks to a face-off win, pretty much over. And the Toronto Maple Leafs go into the break on a high.